Nu handlar det om Philadelphia och New York Rangers.
He's not going to start. He is sitting on the bench, but folks, you saw what happened in the pregame warm-up. These teams are hot, and Theo Fleury is as hot as anybody about some of the things that have been said by a couple of the Flyers, including Brashear's willingness to go after Eric Lindros physically in this game. How that plays out, we're going to find out. We're underway. The return of Eric Lindros to Philadelphia. They have started the lines that are not particularly fighting lines. They're regular lines that play together. Well, he's not the big boy.
With the one exception, Donald Brashear is out there.
Eric Lindros isn't. That'll be whistled on a hand pass. Tom Peel, Don Van Massenhoven will be the referees for this game. Gerald Gauthier and Johnny Murray will be the linesmen.
Slowly but surely, we're heating up here. Eric Weinrich with a shove on Eric Lindros. He lost his footing simply because he was bent on making that pass. Lindros could have kept his footing there, but he wanted to make the pass. There's Fleury, chop, chop, chop. When he finally does get off of Roman Čechmánek, Čechmánek comes up swinging.
Only one penalty, and it's on Čechmánek. So the Philadelphia goaltender picks up the minor for roughing. At 5:07, John LeClair will serve the minor.
Somebody on the ice has to serve it.
And obviously he is not happy with the call.
Ooh. Well, Fleury's lucky that first one missed with the blocker. Fleury was chopping away pretty good too, but I guess the puck hadn't been frozen, so why not chop? That's why nothing was called on Theo Fleury.
Well, the New York Rangers have had a disastrous power play. They haven't scored in their last 25 chances over 6 games.
But this is, they've changed it all around, Gary. This is their second unit. Big Steve McKenna will be in front. When we see Lindros come out, he should line up as a point man.
This is Malakoff working along the blue line with Brian Berard. Two in front, score! May have been deflected on a shot from the point by Dvorak. And the Rangers take a 1-0 lead.
The Rangers practiced their power play almost their entire practice yesterday. The new alignment has Radek Dvorak playing the half boards on his forehand. He is interchangeable with Mike York on the half boards. Roman Čechmánek created his own problem by taking the penalty, but here is Dvorak on the half boards, launched a knuckleball. Did it deflect off big Steve McKenna? It might have hit Mike York. Both of them were in front. So how long did that take for them to score there?
We'll get the time on it, but about 5 seconds.
Four, five seconds? 14 seconds. It looks like the practice paid off yesterday. 14 seconds to pay dividends.
Now the Rangers are in a 5-game losing streak, and during that streak they have not scored the first goal in any of those games. The power play during that streak, 0 for 23. They score on a power play,
right,
with 14 seconds in.
And that's their second unit. When I talked to Ronnie Lowe before the game and I said, what about Eric Lindros on the point? He hasn't played that as a New York Ranger, and he hardly played it as a Flyer. He said, look, did our power play get any worse?
Radek Dvorak gets his 10th goal. Brian Berard and Malakoff are credited with the assist at 5:21. And the Rangers have a 1-0 lead. Rangers beat Philadelphia early this season 4-2. That was at the Garden in New York. Richter and Čechmánek with the goaltenders there as well. Big time hit, Luke Richardson, who can do that. And a retaliatory shot, and here we go behind the net. Barnaby wants to drop the gloves, and Richardson won't. Now they do. Barnaby and Richardson.
Oh, man! Matt Barnaby kept egging Luke Richardson on, and Luke Richardson looked like he was not going to take the bait. Finally, to surprise Barnaby, Luke Richardson planted his right skate blade and threw a big right straight at Barnaby. And I'm not sure whether it connected or not. Barnaby looked like he wasn't hurt on the play.
If some of you think we are in the 60s, 70s in Philadelphia, there's a reason for that.
And we're not talking about the wardrobes. And here it is. Barnaby just chased Richardson down. Richardson kept backing up. I don't want to go. I'm not going to take the penalty. Bang! No, he missed with the first two. Matt Barnaby was quick enough to lower his head. So no harm done to Matt Barnaby. Flyers kind of liked it. The guy shaking his fist is Todd Fedoric, the guy they call the fridge, all 250 pounds of him.
Mark Messier did not make this trip with the New York Rangers. He has been out now 4 games, and Messier with a bad shoulder is a question mark for what's going to happen with him, but he's not playing. And that one dumped to the side of the net. Packer was there, cleared it around, bounced off the boards on the far side where Paul Ranheim knocked it down. Rangers able to get it back to center ice. Dale Purrington, who had been on the RL, comes off it today, that injured list, as he had bad ribs, but he's playing today.
Here we go.
Now we got another center ice.
Here we go.
The big boys are out there. Todd Fedoric, number 29 of Philadelphia.
Steve McKenna with his reach, all 6'8". Oh, man.
Two heavyweights.
Just a takedown by Todd Fedoric, who is trained and competitive in martial arts. But big Steve McKenna got his long arm locked on and locking Fedoric out. But this didn't take long. They came. First, it was Dave Karpa. That will tell you, if you don't know what's inside Fedoric's uniform, what is there? 250 pounds on a 6'2" frame.
Red Wings, the number one team in the NHL. You'll see them going against each other. Full national telecast Wednesday. That one deflected back to the point. Desjardins shot. Didn't get it in. Roenick's got it. Power play opportunity underway, and they are gunning. Richter makes the save. Leach went after it. Couldn't get it. Desjardins all the way in from the point. We've seen Desjardins cutting in every chance he's had. He's down there playing the forward position now in front of the net with the Rangers clear.
Well, the Flyers are trying to get something going in their power play, and if the shot isn't there from the point and they move it down low, you can watch for Desjardins to sneak in from his side for a backdoor play.
See those penalty minutes piling up. Back in behind the net. Got jammed. Philadelphia's Gagne with it. Gagne, Recchi, Roenick up front. Back up. Janssen shot. Blocked. Dvorak. Good play. Letting Dvorak down on the ice. Put the body in front of that one. Down to 57 on this Philadelphia power play. Desjardins hard around to the near side. Philadelphia looking. Trying to get somebody set up in front, but the Rangers have been able to get to the puck and not allow Philadelphia to get it set. Sylvain Lefebvre was the man battling there with Dvorak. In the corner, loose again. DePita goes by to help a little screen here. Weinrich working one of the points along the blue line. Roenick had it poked away to Dvorak. Weinrich able to hold it in. From the left side, save made by Richter. Deflected. McGillis had the opportunity. Still looking down low. Score, Jeremy Roenick!
What a play by John LeClair. What a play. The Rangers did a great job on this kill. LeClair just outthought them. It looked like he was going to go back to the point. That was his number one option. The Rangers thought he was going to go back to the point. Instead, he looked over his shoulder and saw Roenick. But did Jeremy Roenick catch a break on this or what? The shot was going wide until it hit the skate blade of Mike Richter and went into the Rangers' net. If it doesn't hit Richter's skate, it looked to me like it was going to go between Richter and the post.
Watch the two guys on the far side against the boards. Brashear, there they go. They talked about it before the drop of the puck. Brashear, Sandy McCarthy. They are the two big heavyweights expected to fight in this game.
Oh, Brashear went for the grab first. And this is what he likes to do. Grab on and then start to throw him. Sandy McCarthy goes with both hands. He's got a good left, but Brashear's got a major league lock on McCarthy now. It looks like Sandy McCarthy would like that. I was going to say, it looks like McCarthy wants to lock him out and throw him, but there McCarthy's grabbing on too.
These are the top one and two teams in the division. Atlantic Division. So there are points at stake. That coupled with the language that went on, especially by Bryce Shears about Lindros's return, created some fire.
Look at this. You won't be needing this helmet, McCarthy said when he ripped off Bryce Shears' helmet. Once you get into this situation as a fighter, I mean, it's a lot of technique and smart. You just don't stand back and throw wild haymakers. And these guys both have a lot of experience in this kind of hockey fighting, what you're seeing right there in close.
There's a good old-fashioned fight right there by two guys who talked about doing it, did it, and then as soon as the linesmen move in, they were more than willing to just separate and go away. We'll get the penalties after we check in with John and J.D.